The Harry Potter franchise may not be in the best place right now. J.K. Rowling is losing her mind in the worst way, and the Fantastic Beasts spin-off films are decent at best. But when you think about the high the franchise was on during its initial movie run, you can see why so many people fell in love with it, even if they didn't read all the books. And shame on you if you didn't. Anyway, the cast of the movies was top-notch, and yet it's been 19 years since the first film came to theaters, so that's a lot of life progression to cover. So, allow us to show you the Harry Potter cast, then and now. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Daniel Radcliffe. Daniel Radcliffe is best known for playing Harry Potter, the titular character of the series, who learns on his 11th birthday that he is a wizard. This was one of Radcliffe's first acting credits, but he was featured in The Tailor of Panama, 2001, alongside Pierce Brosnan and Jamie Lee Curtis a few months before Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone was released. In between filming the Harry Potter series, Radcliffe appeared in a few movies, including December Boys. After the series ended, Radcliffe starred in the horror film The Woman in Black, the drama Kill Your Darlings, and the rom-com What If. He later appeared in Judd Apatow's Trainwreck as the dog walker, co-starred as Igor opposite James McAvoy in Victor Frankenstein, and played Manny in the film Swiss Army Man. The actor has also appeared on TV series like SkyArt's One's A Young Doctor's Notebook and TBS's Miracle Workers, which has been a surprising hit for TBS and has become an anthology series of sorts, with Radcliffe continuing to star. Outside of film, Radcliffe's theater credits include roles in the 2011 revival of How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying, The Cripple of Inishman, and Endgame. Rupert Grint. Rupert Grint played Ron Weasley, Harry's best friend at Hogwarts and the youngest boy in the Weasley family. Sorcerer's Stone was Grint's first acting credit, which honestly says a lot when you think about it. While filming the series, the English actor also appeared in a few films like Cherry Bomb, the same year that Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2 released in theaters. Grint appeared in Ed Sheeran's Lego House music video. He went on to appear in films including Into the White, Charlie Countryman, CBGB, and Moonwalkers. Grint made his theater debut in the 2013 West End play Mojo, and then had a leading role in the 2014 Broadway play It's Only a Play, alongside acting giants Matthew Broderick and Nathan Lane. Recently, Grint has found success on TV, with roles on Netflix's Sick Note, Crackle's Snatch, and Apple TV Plus's Servant. He's also gotten a partner in life and had a kid, much to the delight of fans. Emma Watson. Emma Watson played Hermione Granger, the top witch in her class and best friend to Ron and Harry. Sorcerer's Stone was also Watson's first acting credit, which again shows just how good she was that this was her first role on screen. And trust me when we say the movies wouldn't have been the same without Watson. In between filming Harry Potter, Watson appeared in Ballet Shoes and voiced a character in The Tale of Despero. In 2011, Watson announced that she would be studying at Brown University. She graduated in 2014 with a bachelor's in English literature. While in school, Watson starred in a number of popular films, including My Week with Marilyn, The Perks of Being a Wallflower, and The Bling Ring. In 2013, Watson also played herself in the Seth Rogen and Evan Goldberg apocalyptic comedy, This Is the End. In 2017, the English actress starred as Belle in the Disney live-action remake of Beauty and the Beast. And in 2019, she was part of the star-studded cast of Greta Gerwig's Little Women. One could very easily argue that of the big three, Emma Watson had the most success, due to her being in those two very successful films. We'll just have to see where things take her next. Tom Felton. Hogwarts bully Draco Malfoy was played by English actor Tom Felton. Before starring as Malfoy, Felton had appeared in a few movies, including Anna and the King, Throughout filming Harry Potter, he also appeared in The Disappeared, Get Him to the Greek, and Night Wolf. After Harry Potter wrapped, Felton starred as another villain in Rise of the Planet of the Apes, but most of his work has been in smaller budget dramas and thrillers. Felton has also found success on TV. He played Eric Blunt on TNT's Murder in the First, Julian Albert on the CW's The Flash, and Logan on the YouTube original series Origin. In 2018, he played Laertes in Ophelia, and one of his most recent acting credits was in Breaking for Wales. Felton recently starred in A Babysitter's Guide to Monster Hunting and the Dutch period piece The Forgotten Battle. Matthew Lewis. Matthew Lewis appeared in the Harry Potter films as Neville Longbottom. Lewis had previously appeared in one film and on a few TV series, but Neville brought the actor to fame. In 2015, Lewis showed the world that he was all grown up when he posed in his underwear for Attitude magazine. Lewis also continued acting after Harry Potter with roles in films like Me Before You and Terminal. He's appeared on several TV shows, including BBC One's The Syndicate, BBC One's Ripper Street, and ITV's Girlfriends. Most recently, Lewis starred in the comedy Baby Done and on Channel 5's All Creatures Great and Small. Ivana Lynch. Quirky Luna Lovegood was portrayed by Irish actress Ivana Lynch. The character doesn't appear until Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, which was Lynch's first acting credit. But once she appeared on screen, she was a fan favorite from the word go, and is still one to this day. Lynch continued acting in a handful of films, including GBF, Addiction, a 60s love story, and My Name is Emily. In 2013, she reprised her role as Luna in the StarKid Productions musical, A Very Potter Senior Year, which starred Darren Criss. Lynch also competed on Dancing with the Stars in 2018 and came in third place. Outside of acting, Lynch is a committed activist. She became an ambassador for controversial Harry Potter author J.K. Rowling's charity, Lumos, and has worked with other organizations like PETA and Save the Asian Elephants. In 2017, Lynch and actor Robbie Jarvis, who played young James Potter in the films, launched a vegan-focused podcast called The Chick Peeps. And in 2019, she received a Lovey Special Achievement Award for expertly using the internet to promote vegan activism and environmental health through social media, podcasting, and her own beauty line, Kinder Beauty Box. She also did voice work on the animated short Behind the McChicken Wrapper and on the animated Nickelodeon series Rise of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Robert Pattinson. Forgot he was in this franchise, didn't you? Robert Pattinson played one of Hogwarts' Triwizard champions, Cedric Diggory. The character is in the fourth film, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, which was one of Pattinson's first acting credits. His very first was an uncredited role in Vanity Fair, which starred Reese Witherspoon. After Harry Potter, Pattinson starred in How to Be and Little Ashes, before becoming a household name as Edward Cullen in the Twilight Saga. He also went on to star in popular films like Remember Me, Water for Elephants, The Lost City of Z, Good Time, and High Life. In 2019, he starred in the Oscar-nominated Robert Eggers film The Lighthouse, opposite Willem Dafoe. Pattinson recently starred in Christopher Nolan's Tenet and Netflix's The Devil All the Time, and he's set to play the superhero in the upcoming Matt Reeves-directed Batman film. Alan Rickman. Sadly, we must end this list with a tribute. A tribute to the late great actor, Alan Rickman. Rickman was a legend on the silver screen, given his deep voice and amazing talents in regards to acting. But many will forever remember him as the teacher Severus Snape, the man who was always berating Harry Potter and his allies. Sadly, much to the shock of the world, he died at the age of 69 from cancer. But he will be remembered forever for his roles on screen. So, what do you think? What do you think of this look at the cast of Harry Potter and how they're doing nowadays? Are you surprised by the career paths of some of these actors? When the movies came out, which of these characters was your favorite? What movie is the best of the eight in your mind? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.